Hello everyone. Today I'm going to share with you a vegetarian recipe made up with raw banana. Even though it's made with a not so well received vegetable, raw banana, but the eventual outcome is very good. You will love what we are going to make. Raw banana kofta. For raw banana kofta curry, here I have taken 5 raw bananas or green bananas. I've cut them in half so that they don't turn black. I've soaked them in water. And with this I'm taking 3 small to medium sized potatoes. I may not need all 3 of them, but we'll see. Apart from the main ingredients, green banana and potatoes, we will need salt, turmeric powder, coriander powder, cumin powder, red chili powder, whole cumin seeds, few whole dry red chilies, carom seeds or ajwain, garam masala powder, some cinnamon sticks and green cardamom, bay leaves, finely chopped coriander leaves, amchur powder or dry mango powder, garlic paste, ginger paste, 1 large onion finely chopped, 1 large tomato finely chopped, and 1 bowl of gram flour or besan. We will be cooking the whole thing in sunflower oil. The first step is to boil the raw bananas and the potatoes. I've added 1 teaspoon of salt and 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder to boil these raw bananas. I'm pressure cooking them. So since the bananas are already almost filling the half of the cooker, so in a separate pressure cooker I have kept the potatoes for boiling. So we'll allow them to boil and we'll come back to you after that. Potatoes and bananas both are properly cooked now. Make sure you do not overcook them, and once they are boiled, take them out of water. We do not want any excess water in either of these. Now the boiled potatoes and the boiled bananas in plates, I'll allow them to cool down. You will notice sometimes in some of the banana pieces, if the banana comes out and the shell remains like this, do not throw the shell, the skin of the banana. If your bananas are fresh and green, then remember the banana skins also have lots of nutrients, so I won't throw them. I will grind them in a mixer and use them. The boiled bananas and the potatoes have cooled down. I have peeled the potatoes. I have also removed the skin part from the boiled raw bananas, and I preserved the skin as they were very fresh and green, so I'm not going to discard them. What I'll now do is roughly grind the banana peels, mash the boiled raw bananas, and grate 2 of the potatoes. I'll preserve 1 potato. If I require, only then I will use it. The boiled banana peels in smaller pieces so it's easy to grind, and I'm going to grind them roughly. One tip is, when you are grinding the banana skins, make sure before you put into the mixer jar itself, you have taken out or squeezed out any excess water. The banana peels from the boiled raw bananas, which I have now grounded into a semi-smooth paste. I have grated 2 potatoes. I kept 1 in reserve. We'll use it if required. And here's my mashed boiled raw bananas. Now we are going to combine all of this together. To this mixture, now I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of carom seeds, 1 teaspoon of amchur powder or dry mango powder. I will prepare a tadka or tempering by frying these cumin seeds and the dry red chilies in a little bit of oil, and I'll add that also to this mixture. For the tempering, I've heated up 1 tablespoon of oil. To that, I'm going to add this 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds and also these 3 tiny red chilies. I'm going to add them. Carefully because it's very hot. Just crush these chilies further and mix everything together nicely. Now that everything is mixed together nicely, to this I'm going to be adding about 3 tablespoons of gram flour. Don't add more gram flour in the beginning, as we don't want too much of gram flour in this. We're using the gram flour and the boiled potato for binding only, so don't want excess of that. Here I've heated up in this kadhai 1.5 cup of oil. First heat it up nicely, then change it to medium temperature. Now I will add little by little small portions from the mixture, form koftas like this, and we'll drop them in the hot oil and fry them in batches till all koftas are well fried and golden brown from all sides. Here's the gravy. I've heated up 2 tablespoons of oil. Now to that I'm adding 1 large onion finely chopped, and I'm going to fry the onion till it's golden. After 4 minutes of frying, onions have turned golden. To this now I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of ginger paste and 1.5 teaspoons of garlic paste, and I will start fry this again on medium flame till the raw smell of ginger and garlic is gone. In 1 minute, now the raw smell of ginger garlic is gone. To this now I will add finely chopped 1 large tomato, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and we'll stir fry again the whole thing on medium flame till the tomatoes melt. After 3-4 minutes, now the tomatoes are melting. So now to this I will add 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, and 1.5 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder. And I'm going to stir fry the whole thing again till everything is mixed well and oil starts coming out from the sides. For another 3 minutes of frying with intermittent stirring, you can see now the tomatoes have completely melted and oil has started coming out from the sides. You can see here. So now we'll switch off the gas, we'll let it cool down, and then we're going to grind this into a smooth paste. Masalas cooled down, I ground them into the smooth paste. Now we'll proceed further by preparing the gravy. Up 1 tablespoon of oil again into this pan, and now I will add to this bay leaves, cinnamon sticks, some green cardamoms into this. I'm going to fry them till nice smell comes from these. Second, nice smell has started coming from these fried garam masalas. Now to this, I'm going to add this ground masala paste, and I have kept the flame low. To stir fry this masala again with this garam masalas for a few seconds. Next stage, if you want, as per your personal preference, you may add a little bit of sugar to balance the taste of the gravy. Here I am not using sugar, but it's totally up to you. Now this masala is fried for about 40 seconds. To this I will add 1/2 a glass of water. Now I'll mix these and let it come to a boil. The gravy has started boiling. To this I'll add 1 more glass of water. Mix everything and let it come to a boil on medium flame. The gravy has been boiling for about 1 minute now. It's already very smooth gravy. However, to make it more creamy, you can add either 1 tablespoon of cashew nut paste, or you can add a little bit of cream to this. I will add to this the last thing, which is 1/2 a teaspoon of garam masala powder. Mix it well and your gravy is ready now. You might be thinking, where are my koftas? Well, koftas you should always add only probably 10 minutes before serving. And always keep a little bit of extra gravy, as koftas, once added to the gravy, tend to soak the gravy. Our koftas are now ready to be served. So, I'm going to pour the gravy on top of these koftas. I'm going to finish it off by adding a little bit of cream on top of this and some finely chopped green coriander leaves. There you go. Raw banana kofta curry is ready to be served. Raw banana kofta curry is ready, and you saw how interesting it is. And since we are using it with the skins, it's even more nutritious than the raw banana's flesh itself. Raw banana has a lot of vitamins and minerals into it. Along with the skin, it becomes rich with fiber as well. Try this recipe. It might be slightly time taking, but it's totally worth it. You will love this recipe with rice or with roti and paratha. And if you like the recipe, please give me a thumbs up, share with your family and friends, subscribe to the channel. That will encourage me a lot. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye. Happy cooking.